So let's start class now. Okay. So we will study circuit theory. And particularly we study So I think that board is visible, na? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Board is visible.
Okay.
Now, sir.
Okay. Now let me draw an electrical network for which we'll have a treatment of graph theory, and we'll find oriented graphs. Okay. Then we'll develop that tie set, and also we'll develop this equilibrium equations. Okay. So let me draw first this network that we have to study. This is 5 ohm. And this is 10 ohm. So this is the circuit, okay? So for that, of this graph, we have to make a, this out of this network, we have to make a graph, okay? So what we have to do it? Make a oriented graph for the above electrical network. Also find equilibrium equations . This is the Hattie's electrical network is given. Based on this electrical network, we'll be finding oriented graph for it, and also we'll find equilibrium equation for the above network. Okay. So now you all know that to do so, we have to identify the nodes first. So this is one node. Okay. This is another node, and this is another node, and this is another node. So number of nodes. Nodes n is equal to 4. Now let us give the name for the nodes. So let us give the this particular for this I am demarcating as a node A, and this is node B, this is node C, and this is node D. Okay. And also, yes, so there are 4 nodes: 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Also, we need to know the number of branches. So number of branches that is designated as a B is equal to 6. Okay, so you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So the number of branches is equal to 6. Okay, now what we have to do? We have to transfer this actual network into a graph and that oriented graph. So let us first draw a graph for this particular network. So now let us draw here the graph. So this is node 1, this is B, this is node C, and this is D. This is A, B, C, and D. So this is a graph for the network given. Now I want to make it a oriented graph, and you all know that if I want to make an oriented graph, then I have to give the direction arrows. So let me give arrows. Arrows I am giving. That is this. It is this. Okay. So this. Then this. And this. And say for this. Okay. So now it has become a, from the graph, we have made it oriented graph because we have attached arrow to this particular graph. Now, term is over because we have drawn an oriented graph that was given in the question. So this is an oriented graph. But if I want to find this equilibrium equation for this above network, then I have to get a tree. I have to get a tree for this oriented graph. Okay. So let me draw a tree for this oriented graph. For example, I can draw this tree. And we also know that many trees can be made out of this graph. But choosing, I am one out of many. So this is this. This is this. A. Now these are the links. Okay. So this is a that is a tree for it. So let me give arrows. Now this is a tree. Now what I have to do now, I have to demarcate the branch name also. Okay, because I have demarcated nodes. Okay, I also need to give the branch name. Okay, say so I am giving here the branch name here. Then I will translate this branch branch name to this trees and to the graph. So let's say this is one. Branch, this is two, this is three, this is four, this is five, and this is six. Okay. Similarly, these branch names will be translated to this graph. Okay. So if I put it here, it's the same thing I'll be putting. So this is one, this is two, this is three. This is four, this is five, and this is six. Okay. So here also I can put the same thing. So this is one, this is two, this is three, this is four, this is five, and this is six. So now this, we have drawn an oriented graph and we have got a tree for it. And also we know in the formula that number of links. Can you tell me that what should be the formula for the number of links of a tree? So anyone can tell that formula for number of links of a tree? That formula?
Sir, in minus one.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
The formula is n minus one. N equal to n equal to node, the formula is n minus one.
The number of links that formula that we have given? formula for number of links of a tree.
Sir, formula is n minus 1.
Number of links of a tree is equal to b minus n minus 1. Okay. So, b is the number of branches and n is the number of nodes. So, now if I compare this thing with this particular the network that we have got it, so here b, number of branches is equal to 6 and number of nodes is equal to 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, minus 1. So, that is 6 minus 3. So, this is 3. So, number of links of a tree is 3. So, for this particular graph, you see that here, so the total number of links that we have got, that is 3. You see this particular graph also, there are 3 links, that is 1, 2, 3. So, this our the tree that we have drawn and the number of links that is satisfying with the given equation, that is b minus n minus 1. So, this equation tells that for this particular network, there should be only 3 links. Also, you see that there are 3 links, that is 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So, I think this is clear. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, now we have got the number of links based on the equation and also we have drawn it. Now, next thing we should go for, that is our task, that second task that we have, that is we have to find equilibrium equations for the above network. Okay. Now, in the last class, I had told you the definition of this tie set. And here I'll be adding one more few words here, that find equilibrium equation for above network based on tie set. Okay. Based on tie set. So, we have to find equilibrium equation based on tie set rule. Okay. So, in the last class, I told you the that what is the definition of tie set. And I told, if you remember, that a tie set is a fundamental loop, okay, of a graph with respect to a tree that contains only one link and rest all are branches or twigs. Do you remember this definition that I told you in the last class?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so once again, I'm repeating, you can write it in your book that you please write. You just write the definition of tie set once again. Okay, so write a tie set is a fundamental loop. A tie set is the fundamental loop. Are you writing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, a tie set is a fundamental loop of a graph with respect to a tree. So, have you written? A tie set is a fundamental loop of a graph with respect to a tree that contains only one link, and the remaining all are twigs or branches, Is it clear? My words are clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Start writing the definition of this tie set.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So once again, I am repeating: a tie set is a fundamental loop of a graph with respect to a tree that contains only one link, and the remaining all are twigs or branches. Okay. So here, okay. So this is a link. Three links we have got with respect to this network, and there are twigs. This is a twig or branches. So this is also a twig or branches. Okay. So this particular network has three links and three twigs or three branches. Okay. So twigs are 1, 2, and 3, and links are 1, 2, and 3. I think this is clear.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what I have to do that I have to find a equilibrium equation for the above network based on the tie set. Okay. So for that you can write a definition for the equilibrium equation. Just you write a definition for equilibrium equation. Okay. You write.
Sir.
Okay. You write the equilibrium equation is a set of equations. Is a set of equations. Set of equations that completely describe. That completely describe. That completely describe a network. That completely describe the state of a network. At any time instant. Have you written this?
Yes, sir.
Sir, okay. Please repeat again.
Equilibrium equation is a set of equations that completely describe the state of the network. Okay. So okay. As we solve this network, we'll understand more about the meaning of this equilibrium equation. You all know that in the last class I told that we should be able to find branch current, branch voltage, nodal voltage, and many other things. So through this equilibrium equations, we can get all those data. Is it correct? Okay.
Yes,
now, if I want to find this equilibrium equation based on this tie set, so we have to do the further processing. So let me do those processes. Okay. So I am removing what I have written here. Okay. Also, I am removing this. Okay.
Okay.
So I'll be following this particular tree, and based on this tree, I'll be making a tri-set matrix. So now I'm going to make a tri-set matrix. Okay. So tri-set matrix, I'll be making at making a tri-set matrix. Actually, it is very very simple. If you see this particular tree. And based on this, if I want to make a tri-set matrix, so that actually we can make or we can create this equilibrium equation. So that is the thing I am doing. Okay. So based on this particular tree, I'll be making or I'll be forming tri-set matrix. Okay. And if you see that, as I told that a tri-set is basically a loop. Okay. And basically a fundamental loop that contains one and only one link. And rest all twigs or branches. So we can one tie set. I can take this because this is forming a loop, and this is forming another loop, and this is forming another loop. So we can have for this above tree, we can have three tie sets, three fundamental tie sets. We can have say this is or means that three fundamental loops we can have. Tie set means it is a fundamental loop. Okay, so this is a fundamental loop because why this is a fundamental loop? Or why this is a tie set? Because you see, if you notice the triangle, you see in this triangle there is only one link. Okay, rest all means there are two branches. So rest all should be twigs or branches. So naturally, if I take this in this particular triangle or in this particular loop, we have only one link and there are two branches. So nothing more. Okay, so there is only one link and rest all branches or rest all twigs. So this particular loop satisfies the definition of a tie set. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Similarly, if you loop this loop, so this will be forming a second tie set. This also has only one link. This is only the link, and rest all branches means there are remaining two branches or twigs. So this is another twig, and this is another twig. So this is also a fundamental loop, or this is also a tie set. Okay. So similarly.
Yes, sir.
If I look at this, also you see this that I got that a tie set or a loop that will be fundamental only if it has the only one link and rest all branches or twigs. Here also you see there is only one link that is shown with a dotted line because we show links with a dotted line and we show branches or twigs with a solid line. So this line is indicating a link and only one link for this loop and there are two twigs. That is, this is one twig and this is another. So you can think that all these three loops, they follow or they have the properties of a tie set. Okay, is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so this is a loop. So this is a tie set. So this is also a loop. So this is another tie set. So this is also a loop. So this is another tie set. Okay. So based on these three tie sets or based on these three loops, we'll be forming tie set matrix, and it is as simple as water. It is very, very simple. You just and you stop. You can stop me at any point of my lecture if you think that you have not understood. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What I am doing here? I am forming tie set matrix based on this particular tree. Okay. So now to form a tie set matrix, we have to go for simple things. So, okay, here you write, you see that I am forming a table. Okay, here I am writing branches. Okay, here I'll be writing the branches, and here I'll be like writing the loops or tie set. So you see, it is so simple. I have drawn two lines. Okay, here I am writing branches or twigs, whatever you say. Okay, branches or twigs, and here I am writing tie set or loop. Okay, so and you know, because underneath I am drawing one more row, because there are many branches, means as per this network, as per this electrical network, there are six branches. So naturally, I'll have a six column. That is one, this is two, this is three, this is four, this is five, and this is six. So there are, as this block has a six branches, so naturally they are demarcated as one, two, three, four, five, and six branches. And this side will have a loop. So now if I talk about, now say I am taking now one by one I'll go. So I am talking of let me take of the first loop. Okay, so this is also I am giving that is loop numbering. Say I am considering this is loop one. So see, as per this direction of link, I have to give the direction of this loop, of this arrow. So this is loop one I am considering. So I am writing L1. Okay. And if I say that this loop is containing, or through this loop I1 current is flowing. So in the bracket I am writing I1. So what I have done here. So as there are three loops, if I it is bigger than I number them, then it will be very clear for us that which loop we are talking about. So here this particular loop, I have given a name loop one. So and also I assume in this loop one, say I1 loop current is flowing. So in the bracket you see that I have written I1. So this is a loop number one, and that is carrying current I1. Okay. So now similarly I can give the numbering of this loop. So here I am saying, so through the loop this current is flowing. This is loop two, and in this loop I2 is current flowing. You see that I have given arrow direction in the direction of link. You see that in this direction I have given. Okay.